I'd like to call a meeting to order for the Committee of the Hall of Control for Tuesday, June 12, 2018.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Hoffman?
Here.
Mr. Condit?
Here.
Mr. Petrovic?
Here.
Ms. Kovac? Here. Mr. Wiggins?
Present.
Ms. Lindley?
Here.
Minutes for approval of the meeting, May 29, 2018. Do I have a motion?
Move to approve.
Second.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Condit?
Yes.
Mr. Petrovic?
Yes.
Ms. Kovac?
Abstain.
Mr. Wiggins?
Yes.
Ms. Lindley?
Yes.
Mr. Hoffman?
Yes. Are there any amendments to the agenda, please?
Yes, Mr. President. I'd like to make a motion that we add Resolution 63-2018, a resolution to award a contract to Tri-More Corporation for completion of the Nautilus Trail West Reconstruction and Waterline Improvement Project in an amount not to exceed $1,452,941 and declaring an emergency.
Is there a second?
Second.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Petrovic?
Yes.
Ms. Kovac?
Yes.
Mr. Wiggins?
Yes.
Ms. Lindley?
Yes.
Mr. Hoffman?
Yes.
Mr. Condit?
Yes.
Okay, very good. Any other amendments?
No, sir.
No? Okay, good. Reports. The mayor is not here, so we'll move right to the law director.
Nothing to report.
Engineering.
The only thing I have is that we do ask that you suspend the rules and vote to pass the added legislation by emergency so that we don't create any further delays in the Nautilus Trail project.
Okay. Any questions? Service department. No report. Athletic club. No report. Fiscal officer is not here. Police chief.
No report.
Fire chief.
That was posted.
It was posted. Were there any questions about that? Architectural review board.
The ABR's next meeting will be on the 25th at 7 o'clock in this room.
Very good. Thank you. Planning zoning. No report. Board of Zoning Appeals.
We approved variances for two decks.
Okay, thank you. Finance?
No report.
Cable has a report. We met last week and went over what the normal business model is as far as how much revenue came in and those kinds of things. But what was interesting is they're actually going to take on a new name for Cable 9. They're going to keep the Cable 9 logo, but it's going to be a second one, and it's called Community Focus. And what's interesting about that is they will have an app. If you have a smart television, or if you're getting your service from some of the minor, you know, like the libraries and things like that, you can actually get right into their programming. Not all of their programming, but for instance, when they have concerts or athletic events, graduation ceremonies, those types of things, you'll be able to, with your smart TV and using that app, be able to use it. You do not have to be a member of cable company that's Spectrum. Yeah. You do not have to be a member of Spectrum. Anyone who wants it can get into that. That probably be available in the next month. They're applying for the app now. And when it comes out, obviously, they're going to send out information so people will know exactly how to get into that app. Okay. Communications.
Well, we sent out the first newsletter, and then it hit the servers, and then it stopped. So, unfortunately, as all this tech stuff does sometimes, Kevin, though, is doing a good job. He's contacting the company, and so we've been working at it, trying to get that all snafu'd and out there. So, it's still in the works. I just want to let everybody know. But, you know, sometimes that stuff happens, unfortunately. I just wanted to also say a big thank you to Stacy, because She's always my awesome wordsmith and fixes up everything that I write. And I just wanted to say thank you so much. Because thank you so much. You make me sound so much better than I am. So I appreciate it. Our next meeting is Monday, July 9th, here at Village Hall from 7 to 8. All are welcome.
Very good. Thank you. Long-term community development. No report. Records?
No.
No report. And Jed, Mr. DiCarlo.
Jed met last Tuesday at the Township Hall. We weren't able to do any voting because there was only one Township member present. All the Village members were accounted for. We did have a presentation from Molly Smith from Kent State. And her title is way too long for me to even try to say. But she talked about the scholarships and maybe some of their future plans for the academic center. And our next meeting will be Tuesday, September 4th, which is the day after Labor Day, 7 o'clock here at the Village Hall. And that's all I have, unless Rod, Walter, Mark want to add something.
Well, that was, for me, that was a very good summary. Anyone? Okay, thank you. Moving on to legislation. Ordinance 13-2018, an ordinance to adopt a tax budget for fiscal year commencing January 1st, 2019, and ending December 31st, 2019, and that's first reading, Mr. Wiggins. Resolution 52-2018 is a resolution to hire independent contractors as fitness instructors for the Reminderville Athletic Club and declaring an emergency. And I think the request is that it does get passed by emergency, correct? Okay. Resolution 58-2018 is a resolution to hire Ryan Law as a full-time police officer with the Village of Reminderville. That is second reading. Resolution 61-2018 is a resolution to accept the resignation of Catherine Jacobs from the Village of Reminderville Civil Service Commission and declaring an emergency. Resolution 62-2018 is a resolution to authorize the mayor to enter into an agreement with Dial My Calls Emergency Notification System not to exceed $500 in credits and declaring an emergency, first reading. We will ask that that be passed by emergency, Mrs. Bellini. And Resolution 63-2018, the resolution to award the contract to Trimore Corporation for completion of the Nautilus Trail West Reconstruction and Waterline Improvement Project in an amount not to exceed $1,452,941.00 and declaring an emergency.
Just to clarify that, that's the amount on there was provided by OHM. That's the amount that they determined it will take to finish the job that tracks did not complete. So, and they probably based that on Trimore's bid.
And they mean their original bid?
Correct.
Okay, so it was not altered at all?
That I don't know, whether it was altered or not, but they've made that determination as to what it's going to take to finish the job.
Okay,
good. So now is this...
Go ahead.
Is this costing the village more now through Trimore?
Well, that's...
You know, roughly... I know
no one can tell that right now.
Right.
If there's change orders, obviously, the
right.
answer would be yes, it's going to cost more. But it should not cost us more than Trax's bid. Trax bid more on phase one than Trimore did, and then on phase two and three, I think Trimore's actually a little less.
Okay.
There might actually be a savings on this. I'm not sure, but there might
close.
Be. Yeah.
I know change orders come in all the time. Is this exactly what it is right now, or is this subject to change, the 1 million?
I'm not sure I understand that question, but I'm going to go with... It's exactly what it is right now, and it's subject to change order.
All right.
Question for Terry. that this construction brought to mind. I noticed on the way over here that some road patching had been done. Was that our village, or was that...
Trimore did that as part of the emergency to get us through until this was all through.
Because some big holes had developed on Nautilus on the eastern side of the road, I think it is, northeastern side, and I was pleased to see that that had all been repaired.
Are they pretty close to done with that whole phase of the operation? Because it looked like they finished up today, is that right?
I will say that when we're talking about change orders, the majority of the change orders occurred during the work on the water line and the sanitary sewer. So Cleveland Water and Summit County will absorb the bulk of the increase that was created during those change orders. So the OPWC / Reminderville funds weren't going to come into play until this second portion of the project anyway. So in that respect, the numbers did work out in the village's favor.
Yeah, I think this next phase is just the street stuff, right?
Yes.
And it's probably going to be less subject to change orders because the conditions in the road right away where the utilities were caused most of the change orders. And this is just going to be probably something that's a little more known. The base is a little more known. You know, it's easier to see what's there, so there should be less change orders. That's the way it should be.
Are we voting on that tonight?
Yes.
We're
hoping that we will have an emergency passage of that. Okay. Anything else on that? Old business. New business.
I think this might fall in new business. Stacy, do you want to say a little bit about Fun Day?
Family Fun Day is Saturday, 1 to 4, over at the playground area. Touch truck, rock car, face painter, blue nordes, ice cream truck, petting zoo, pony rides, and hopefully no rain. Because might be a little boring Fun Day if it's raining.
That's going to be beautiful.
Okay, good.
Bad weather ever cause a postponement where it goes to the next day or next weekend?
No, because everything that I booked is very
is
heavily
there,
booked for
yeah.
other events. So the bounce house, I mean, everything would we can
gotcha.
Do.
Yeah, I understand. So,
turn it into a second
fun. Yeah, I mean, we can just enjoy the blossom with the mud.
It's one of those now or never events.
Yeah.
All right. Well, everyone pray for sunshine.
Yeah.
Okay. Is there any other new business?
This is, well, I guess it's new business for me because I wasn't at the last meeting, but I had some concerns about Resolution 58. So I asked Deb to pull some reports, and thankfully she was able to do that not being here, which was great. But I just had, and I know I talked to a few of you about this, and I mentioned it at our work session. I emailed with Chief Buck today. So this is a replacement from an officer from, was it 2010?
I think I said 2012 in the email.
Okay.
And that wasn't an exact date because they were on extended leave. And you're talking about the person that was hired while you were gone.
No, 58.
Ross.
We're on second reading. It's going to be voted on next time.
Yeah, 58 will replace a guy that left in...
Lyle?
Yeah, well, 2017.
2 years ago or 1 year ago?
16.
Yeah, it may have been last week.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, so that's I put Roth in the email.
Okay.
Well, so I guess my concern, so, is I feel that it's more cost effective to just pay the overtime than to hire, to bring in a full-time officer. Because we're at... If we keep going as we are, then we're at about $47,000 in overtime for the year if we keep, which is less than what the first quarter I calculated. So Deb said to bring in a new officer across the village about $90,000.
But you've already authorized to bring that new officer in last year at budget time.
But you're already at where you should be with your budget.
That's because you told me at budget time last year that you understood that the overtime wasn't in there, and depending on the arrest, we had to come back to you and tell you when there was an overtime problem.
But you're
not at that point yet.
You're at 41% of the salary.
Okay.
So we're 50% of the year.
Right, without this person.
Would this add more, since it's a replacement?
Well, some money's not in there.
Okay, you do understand that the person that you're hiring, they're just changing titles. They still work the same shift. They're still working the same hours. You do understand that, right?
Right, but
this is not a guy you're training, is that what you're saying?
Exactly. For instance, you hired Tara at the last meeting full-time, and she didn't do anything other than change her title from part-time to full-time. She stayed on the same shift. She's still working 7 p.m. to 7 a.m., has the same day off. Nothing changed other than the difference. These are the calculations that I did today that show you what the difference is for a full-time officer to a part-time officer.
It costs $90,000 for a new officer.
That's just coming from Deb.
I'm asking the chief, how does it cost that much?
I don't know how it costs that much, to be honest with you. I've got the calculations that I guess if you looked at it as hiring, these are the budgets that I turned in last year. We passed the two people that we're going to hire in 2018. I guess if you hired a new person to start a whole new shift that we didn't have, that it maybe would cost $90,000. But understand that those people are actually still working, and those shifts are still covered.
Thank you.
So I guess if you hired a brand new person that wasn't working there, and there was a brand new shift that we never had before, say noon to 8 p.m., that it would cost $98,000 to hire that person. I've got Deb's calculations, and I don't think they were $98,000. I think they were $81,699 is what she says for a brand new person for a year.
Seems to me it would be their salary plus whatever you paid for them to train them.
Well, it's the salary.
Insurance. I mean,
does that $81,000 include their benefits?
Yes, sir. Okay. So the reason that the budgets get ate into is because of our arrests and our overtime and our booking of people. Been a very busy last 2 months. We've had 15 felony arrests just in the last few months, 15 misdemeanor, or 27 misdemeanor sites. So the opioid crisis is here. We're trying to keep it at bay, but we can only keep it at bay by arresting people and putting them in jail, which creates going to court and creates the overtime. And at the budget hearing, when I met with all of you, I was told, put in there just what you need, and then come back and ask us more if you have overtime. Well, we have overtime, which we knew we were going to have going into it. Now, going into the budget, everybody's vacation was covered because each officer has a certain amount of vacation. All 13 holidays were covered if they worked, and that was in there. But as far as predicting overtime, I can't do it. And as far as what you think, that's not happening. For you to say it's more effective to pay overtime than to hire somebody, you're not understanding how this is working.
Are you short shifts, or I don't understand.
I understand
it's a replacement, but
that person that you're hiring isn't replacing anybody. They're working right now as a part-time officer in that shift. All you're doing is changing titles.
Well, and adding insurance and everything else.
Absolutely. But if that person, as we've all discussed before, if that person decides to take another full-time job elsewhere, because there's a lot of full-time jobs elsewhere, it's going to cost us, in addition to that person that we're going to have to hire back there and is going to have to work that shift, it's going to cost us an additional $20,000 to $30,000 to get another person to the point where we have the people at now that are on the civil service list that are ready to go. It's not going to disappear. That money is not going to disappear. If you say, no, we're not hiring Ryan Roth, that shift is still going to get covered. It's not like we're not going to have anybody out there working the shift. But Ryan Roth is going to go work for another city. And then we're going to have a person that we've got to rehire bring in, retrain, and get to that point. Which is what the whole goal's been for the last 2 or 3 years with the guys that we have lined up now.
Rodney and I, and you can give your version of the meeting, we approached Deborah, we met with her, what was that, 2 weeks ago now? And we discussed the whole issue of what money was available there. We also asked, and I called the chief, and I asked him to meet with Deborah to make sure that this was all lined up. Through no fault of his own, Deborah was not available after that meeting because she went to Washington last week, and then she spent the last 3 days, the next 3 days, and the next one. I left with the impression from Deborah that if there was not enough money in that account, there were other accounts that he would be able to transfer money into. In the conversation that I had with the chief, I made it clear that additional funds were going to be difficult to obtain. He's going to have to live with the budget that he was given. And he, I think, is fully aware of that. I don't know if you got the same information that I just gave Rodney, but that's the way I left the meeting. And I conveyed that to the chief approximately a week ago.
About that, yeah.
So how much is this number going to change the personnel?
It's on that one handout that you have there. In the red. So that number is going to go up by $5,500, which is the difference of $4.78 an hour from the full-time, or from the part-time to the full-time on probation, times the rest of the hours left in this year, which is 1,160 hours, for a total of $5,544.80. The hospitalization, I estimated, because I don't know, so I used a figure of $800 a month, which I know some of my younger guys are at $300 or $400, and I know that I'm at $12. So I picked a number in the middle. That's $4,800 that's going to be added to the Medicare, and $250 more they get for a uniform allowance.
So the total on that is how much?
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 grand.
It was sort of the direction that the conversation took, I think, when we were with Deborah. That's what the addition was.
Yeah, from my notes of utilizing a part-time individual or multiple part-time individuals to equal an 80-hour pay period, which is what a full-time individual would be, and then you do the calculations that you have here. It's, according to the numbers Deborah provided, approximately $51,000 to cover that 80-hour shift all year long with part-time pay. When you move to a full-timer and you add in all these benefits and everything else, you get to around 83. But there is a difference other than just money between covering that with one, two, or three multiple people in a part-time basis versus having a dedicated full-time officer. You can't just do the math delta of $21,000 and say, hey, the village is $21,000 better off to use part-time people than full-time people. We had some discussion of that around the...
And it's a half year, not full.
Yeah. The commitment of the individual, the ability to truly schedule that full-time person, and an extent to rely on them a little bit. So it's in the number, and what we came down to as adding to your discussion, my discussion with Deborah, was that we were asking the chief, is there that other $21,000 in your budget that you can move around to the payroll area and benefits to cover it? And his response to you was yes. And you were going to get that done before this meeting.
And we would choose not to do the driveway that we have happen. Slated for 2018.
Yeah. So, like I said, I totally agree with how Walt summarized the meeting. The only thing I added was a couple of numbers different, and that you made every effort to meet with Deborah last week to put those numbers in the right line item. It just didn't happen last week. It'll happen next week.
And at this point right now, I'm not 100% sure we're going to need you.
Need to.
Right.
But the run rate, as Becky pointed out, the run rate would look like we'll need to move the money.
Just so people know, the reason that I had you go is because you're chairing the finance committee.
Not because you like me a lot?
I do too.
It was my role as president of
finance. There were really two reasons.
Okay, thank you.
Becky, any other conversation you want to have on this?
Well, we're not, this is our second reading, right?
Right, it's going to be voted on at the next meeting. Okay.
So there's still time for more analysis, more questions for those who want it.
Anything else? Move to adjourn? Anyone able to do that?
I move to adjourn the committee of the whole.
Second?
Hold second.
Roll call, please.
Ms. Novak?
Yes.
Mr. Williams?
Yes.
Mr. Laney? Yes. Mr. Hoffman?
Yes.
Mr. Hunter?
Yes.
Yes.
Meeting is adjourned. And we'll go directly into the regular meeting.
All right.
I'd like to call that to order. June 12th, 2018. Pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Hoffman?
Here.
Mr. Condit?
Here.
Mr. Petrovich?
Yes.
Mr. Novak?
Yes.
Mr. Williams?
Yes.
Ms. Lee?
Yes.
We have the minutes, and we need approval, and we had a chance to look at them for the meeting of May the 29th, 2018. Do I have a motion?
Move to accept the minutes. Second.
It's been moved and seconded. Roll call, please.
Ms. Petrovich?
Yes.
Ms. Kovac?
Abstain.
Mr. Wiggins?
Yes.
Ms. Laney?
Yes.
Mr. Hoffman?
Yes.
Mr. Connors?
Yes.
Thank you. Acceptance of financial reports. There was no financial report, so I'm not sure what we're going to accept here, but I don't think we need a motion, really. Okay, are there any additional amendments to the agenda?
Yes, Resolution 63-2018, a resolution to award a contract to Tri-Moore Corporation for completion of the Nautilus Trail West Reconstruction and Water Find Improvement Project in an amount not to exceed $1,452,941.
Okay. Do I have a motion to accept the addition or the amendment?
In reading it is the first motion. I just need a second.
Second.
Okay. Roll call, please.
Mr. Wiggins?
Yes.
Ms. Laney?
Yes.
Mr. Hoffman?
Yes.
Mr. Condit?
Yes.
Mr. Petrovich?
Yes.
Ms. Kovac?
Yes.
Moving on, comments from the public. Are there any comments?
Mary Williams, 10589 Florida Street. I just want this to go on the record that I'm upset about long-term community development. They plant these plants, then they let the grass grow up all in between them. Now it's going to choke them out. I don't know if they don't have somebody to pull this grass, or if they expect the village to hire somebody to do it, or what. But I just wanted it to be on the record that I don't think they're doing the job they're supposed to be doing.
I'm not sure where we stand with that. I remember that when we were getting their report, was it late fall? And they were asking for a budget item because I don't think they wanted to be the one that were maintaining or cleaning. Am I the only one that remembers that? Or?
No, they did ask for money.
They didn't want to do it. And I think they were asking for $1,200 each time or something like that?
Just the first time.
$1,500.
Well, we basically said live within your budget. We didn't add anything to the budget.
This is the pollinator garden, right?
Yeah, which there was there were restrictions on the pollinator garden because it had to be native plants and left in a rustic environment. But that is those specific plants. I don't know if anybody is misinterpreting that we can't garden the area. We're just not to cut those plants. We're to let them naturally replenish themselves. So
you're saying there's weeds that are growing in between?
For sure. It's a lot of grass, and if the grass is left to grow, it's going to choke out plants. I mean, common sense would tell you that.
Yeah,
nobody goes in between the plants and pulls out the wild grass that's growing there.
Yeah.
Can we maybe reach out to them to see what their plan is? I'll get in contact with them.
I'm sorry, I couldn't hear you, Steve.
I'll contact them for the
weekend. Okay, let's see what we can do. I don't know, we can't use our service department for that, or?
They're pretty taxed.
Yeah, that's the problem is when everybody has all these ideas, they forget about who's going to maintain them, and it always falls on service.
Well, I just know we hired a number of I'm assuming they're high school students, and that would be the type of job. Yeah, I would think that would be the kind of thing they might be able to tackle. Is it take a lot of skill to clean that out?
Pardon?
Does it take any skill to clean that out?
No,
could you put me there and could I figure it out?
Sure, I could do it, but I'm not going to. I have my own yard to keep up. But I'm just saying it's just grass and it's growing and eventually it's just going to overtake the plants they want there. And to me, that's...
Well, we'll talk to them and see what they have in mind and then see if we can come up with something. Okay? Any other comments from the public?
Paul Williams, 10589 Florida Street. When I was on council, we had a list of road repairs and projects that were coming out year by year by year by year. Do you still have that list that you know which of the community roads are going to be repaired? I'm asking for one reason.
You're asking for what?
One reason.
Go ahead.
Right now, we have a nice pothole developing on our end of Florida. And the other end of Florida was redone a couple years ago in concrete. I doubt much that they're going to do our end in concrete. Ours was done in blacktop before. They put a wonderful base in there when they redid it. But if we allow potholes to form, the base is going to wash out from underneath. And the hole right now is only like this. And it's the water's going to get in there and break things up. So I was just wondering if there is a list of roads that, like 2020, these are the roads we're going to be looking at.
It could be patched.
If a street's
cleaned. It could be patched before that, yes. But all I'm saying is, when I was on council, we had a list of roads, and we knew which year certain roads were going to be repaired. And I don't know whether you still have that or not. I haven't heard anything like that for a long time.
Terry.
To answer the question, yes, we do. I will provide a copy of that at the next meeting.
Okay.
But potholes will, that doesn't necessarily follow, I'm assuming, a particular year. If a pothole shows up, we're going to fix it.
Yeah, we will patch those as well.
Right. So that would be separate. But if you could get that list of what roads are getting a major work done on them, that would be good.
Yes.
Okay. Any other comments from the public? Okay, then we'll move on to legislation. Ordinance 13-2018 is an ordinance to adopt the tax budget for the fiscal year commencing January 1, 2019, and ending December 31st, 2019. First reading, Mr. Wiggins, who said we do not have to pass by emergency. Resolution 52-2018 is a resolution to hire independent contractors as fitness instructors for the Reminderville Athletic Club and declaring an emergency. Mrs. Blaney.
Move to suspend the rules and pass by emergency.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded. Could we have a roll call, please?
Ms. Blaney?
Yes.
Mr. Hoffman?
Yes.
Mr. Kondik?
Yes.
Mr. Petrovich?
Yes.
Ms. Kovach?
Yes.
Ms. Wiggins?
Yes. Move to pass by emergency.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded to pass. Could I have a roll call, please?
Mr. Huffman?
Yes.
Mr. Kondik?
Yes.
Mr. Petrovich?
Yes.
Ms. Kovach?
Yes.
Mr. Wiggins?
Yes.
Ms. Blaney?
Yes.
Thank you very much. It passes 6-0. Resolution 58, 2018 is a resolution to hire Ryan Roth as a full-time police officer with the Village of Reminderville. Second reading, Mayor Alonzo. Resolution 61, 2018 is a resolution to accept the resignation of Catherine Jacobs from the Village of Reminderville Civil Service Commission and declaring an emergency, and that is being sponsored by Mayor Alonzo.
Move to suspend the rules and pass by emergency.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded by Ms. Kovach. Can we have a roll call, please?
Ms. Conner?
Yes.
Ms. Krejcich?
Yes.
Ms. Kovach?
Yes.
Mr. Wiggins?
Yes.
Ms. Laney?
Yes.
Ms. Crawford?
Yes.
Move to pass by emergency.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded to pass. Could we have a roll call, please?
Ms. Krejcich?
Yes.
Ms. Kovach?
Yes.
Mr. Wiggins?
Yes.
Ms. Laney?
Yes.
Mr. Hoffman?
Yes.
Ms. Conner?
Yes.
62-2018, Resolution 62-2018 is a resolution to authorize the mayor to enter into an agreement with Dial My Calls Emergency Notification System, not to exceed $500 in credits, and declaring an emergency, sponsored by Mrs. Blaney.
Move to suspend the rules and pass by emergency.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded. Can we have a roll call, please?
Ms. Kovach?
Yes.
Mr. Williams?
Yes.
Ms. Laney?
Yes.
Ms. Crawford?
Yes.
Ms. Conner?
Yes.
Ms. Krejcich?
Yes.
Move to pass by emergency.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded to pass that resolution 62-2018. Could I have a roll call, please?
Mr. Williams?
Yes.
Ms. Laney?
Yes.
Ms. Crawford?
Yes.
Ms. Conner?
Yes.
Ms. Krejcich?
Yes.
Ms. Kovach?
Yes.
We have resolution number 63-2018, which is offered by Mayor Alonzo. It's a resolution to award a contract to Trimore Corporation for completion of the Nautilus Trail West Reconstruction and Waterline Improvement Project in an amount not to exceed $1,452,941 and declaring an emergency.
Move to suspend the rules and pass by emergency.
Second.
Been moved and seconded that we pass resolution number 63-2018 by emergency. Could I have a roll call, please?
Ms. Laney?
Yes.
Mr. Hoffman?
Yes.
Mr. Conner?
Yes.
Ms. Krejcich?
Yes.
Ms. Kovach?
Yes.
Mr. Wiggins?
Yes. Move to pass by emergency.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded to pass by emergency. Roll call, please.
Mr. Hoffman?
Yes.
Mr. Conner?
Yes.
Mr. Krejcich?
Yes.
Ms. Kovach?
Yes.
Mr. Wiggins?
Yes.
Ms. Laney?
Yes.
Thank you. Any old business?
I just have a question on that new building going up in the shopping center. Is there any advancement, anything going on that we know of? Do they have an inside plan yet? Or people have been asking me about what's going on.
All I hear is rumors, and I have not heard anything official at all. Does anyone have official?
We have not received anything official.
There's a lot of rumors out there, though, right?
There are plenty of rumors.
So unfortunately, we can't answer your question. Any other old business? New business? Is there a motion? Is there a motion to adjourn, please?
Move to adjourn.
Second.
Been moved and seconded to adjourn. Can we have a roll call, please?
Ms. Conner?
Yes.
Ms. Krejcich?
Yes.
Ms. Kovach?
Yes.
Mr. Wiggins?
Yes.
Ms. Laney?
Yes.
Ms. Hoffman?
Yes.
Can you